Okay. So you guys might think this is fun too, but it's not. What I have here is my fresh FreeBSD install. My GhostBSD didn't start up here anymore. It got always stuck at the USB stuff, and I wanted to figure out if it is a GhostBSD thing or FreeBSD thing, you know, before I slash the hammer on it. Oh dear me, Dirk, you're so mean. I unsubscribe. No, I don't think that happens anymore. It seems that the subscribers I have are the hard knuckles, so they don't start crying when I get loud. I don't want to get loud. But you see, when you got the default panels, it's all not the way it is supposed to be. This has to be vertical, of course, and it has to be on the corner. And if we can, let's see if we can. No, it does the same thing like on Fantoo. I have to figure that out. That's interesting, right? So it makes it all invisible. I don't have a browser yet, so that's what I have. And here I will add my Basilisk. I don't have a packer yet either, so I have to do some installation. I have to figure out. Oh, I did just in install. I have to figure out, like, if I go into. No worries, I'm not in as root logged in. If I go in fstab, they have the typical FreeBSD lookalike. And I would like to have my dev. And I would think, because they call it ADA and ADA1, so, and partition is in 1A and B. So I would think mine might be ADA. I don't know. Is it a 2 or 0? Because I don't have my. My G parted. I can't see, and list bulk doesn't work. So some of your well-known Linux commands do not work here. Well, what the heck? What can we do? This is that's what I bought in for now. Okay, so then I would put in here my mount point, which would be home. And forward slash Dirk. Oh, like I would do it usual. That's how I usually do, right? And then I have a forward slash and I call it dot home because it will be an invisible thing. So, and I don't have it yet here. No, doesn't exist. So all I do is I create a folder. I call it dot home. So I prepare. I will mount it. I just don't have the idea yet what that will be. Because I have no means in a moment to figure out how this hard drive is called and what the partition might be called. So disaster striked. No, it doesn't really. So as you can see, I'm on the way to figure out FreeBSD. I did it before, and I want to see if that gives me the same error messages as Ghost did me. GhostBSD gave me, right? So here that would be extended 4, so like that, and rewrite, and then I would just call it 0.0, and that should work. It looks a little bit funky because I have that in short. So that's extended for read write, and then 0.0. So that should do it once I get there, right? So I stop that. I cannot write more volume. Why? Unknown error. What? But it's there. It's written. Oh, you know what that was. Because I tried to mount that one hard drive with Suna, and that did not work. Oh, let me see if I can do it if I run Suna here with S root. No, it doesn't show me anything. No. Okay, what I want to show is, and that's why I must say, FreeBSD, they did their homework. If I go to network, you see I've got already mounted them. So browse network, of course, nothing is coming. There, Windows Network, click on it, nothing. But that is because most likely Samba is not really configured yet. But that doesn't matter to me much because I can just go in here, the SMB, and go in and say 129.168.100 and then, oh, oops, .145. Dang it. 145. And then here it goes. So it's my remember forever. My super secret passwords. Did it work? No, of course not. So, I don't know, here's my homes, Plex, video, Docker. So that's what's on my NAS. And I did already connect them here. It seems to have problems to remember. So I have to put that in all the time. I have no idea why. It's maybe not too bad having a second security layer. I could try, my browser is packed here, so I haven't got a X-Archiver or something like that installed here, because I have to figure out first how to find them. It doesn't seem to be easy anymore. Email browser, Thunderbird, Waterfox, it's just my Tor browser. Yeah, I don't know if that would work here so easily. Waterfox, we could try, because I don't think that would just work like it. Can I? Because it's a Linux script, right? And I do not believe it would just work here. I'll copy that over. Just to see what it does, right? Let's give it a try here. So that's me, the simple user, giving it a shot. Seems I copied it over. Waterfox, permission execute here, allow. Let's see if it does it. And then, okay, that doesn't work. So now we just go in cd waterfox ls and sh waterfox and let's try this. Syntax error, word unexpected, expecting. Let's try the bin. I mean, and you see, I'm coming here from Linux, so I'm I'm trying to make it work. No, okay. So I can't execute that. No, it's not as easy as I thought, that you can just go and fire it up. But we can try create a launcher. Maybe that works. Call the Waterfox. Just for the giggle of it, command. Maybe that works. Maybe I just did a mistake here. Waterfox should show up here. Launch anyway. Let's see if that works. I doubt it will. And no, it didn't. Invalid encoding. So I think we can scratch this. So it's not Linux, actually. FreeBSD is not Linux. All my tricks don't work, so I have to learn, guys, right? So that's what it is. I will delete this for now. Yeah, I just wanted to show you guys. That's how it looks like. That's my brand new FreeBSD installation. What is here? I can't see much. Let's see if I have... I don't have a settings. Do I have settings? Settings manager. Because it looks just terrible here, so I have to change something. What can we do? Curve could look alright, or dawn. I would like to have it a little bit darker, not like winter. Well, that could do. Icons, here we are, fonts, that's what it is. And that should do, I hope. Windows Manager, Keyboard Focus Advanced, the screen borders to other windows. Well, we can try. Would be interesting to see. However, this is what it is in a moment. Yeah, that's too big. Oh, display settings, you know. Let's go what I can do here in settings. Is display visible? Yes, it is. And I can't go higher than that just yet. It's a little bit slow. It's okay. I will have to install the NVIDIA drivers. So I have to go step by step here, right? So I don't know what that is here. That is, oh, flipping. So what we have to do here is, because I need that in my panel, I need to know that I can see all window buttons. We go in settings. I want to see show windows from all workspaces. Because I don't want to click around and try to search for stuff, which should just be there, right? And yeah, I don't like how it looks like in a moment. I need a little more contrast. Well, that was the wrong one. It's not what I wanted. I wanted to have appearance. I think I need the Windows Manager. I did that already, so now I need the Windows Manager, not the tweaks. And we have to go for the Lola, I think. Oh, that looks terrible. That looks better. Mohili. Mohili it is. See, now I've got something blue here, something colorful. It makes me not well if I can't see colors. Yeah. So it's quite interesting here, being in FreeBSD. You see, that was what GhostBSD did quite well. They themed it. They made lots of things working. And now I have to do it all by myself. Obviously, I cannot mount these things. F-stop 5. Inappropriate file type or format. Oh, how is it? Device permission denied by policy. Okay, I have to get rid of that policy somehow. So if somebody knows how I get rid of that policy, that would be nice, because I do want to mount my drives. I do not want to have a policy denying me opening up my stuff. We can have a look. I haven't seen anything in that F-stop which told me otherwise. Yeah. It's not like in Linux that you can just, you have to type it all every time new. That's good, so you can't see my mistakes. Right? So I don't see policy here. Device mind, mount point, blah, 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 extended 4. Yeah. I must have to add something there. So I have to go really into everything. And let's see what I use on. So you have to do really everything by yourself here. It's hard work, guys. Install-y, htop. I have to find out how I search properly for files here and things like that. What does htop say? Pretty dark, it says. It says Dirk, it's dark. Preferences, appearance. So that does something. Okay, we can see something. Yeah, I can't mount, you see. That's popping up too. Okay. It was from just before. So that is with Simple Screen Recorder running and recording. And I must say, if Simple Screen Recorder is still recording, I think it is. It's writing, yeah? Yes, it is. So frames, time. Yes, it's writing. So it takes far less power. We have seen that on Fanto, it was on 100%. Here on FreeBSD, it's just tickling around on the CPUs. It just tickles them. That's very interesting. I don't have the high resolution here, I must say. You know, you saw the display. I don't have big display resolution, so that makes a difference too, which I don't like. I want to have the big resolution here. But I have to learn while I'm doing. So all FreeBSD users, Vaza64, help me out here. Let me know how I get the resolutions changed. How do I search for packages? And I thought it was by S or search, you know, that I just go here. And then I go package, dash S, and say, let's say VLC. Illegal. I'm illegal. That doesn't work. Maybe I can write search. Yeah. So that worked. I got VLC here. Search for simple scan. Nothing. See, that's I don't understand that. Nothing. I get no output. Well, what does that mean? Oh, now I get a lot. But I can't see if... yeah, I think they haven't had simple scan. They had the G-scan stuff. But we're getting there. So this is a little bit the early impression I have now from FreeBSD. The system is fully updated. There's nothing, not much I can do. I downloaded and extract the ports. And I can reboot. And it boots. It doesn't get stuck on my USB keyboard whatsoever. I don't know what it was, why it is that way. Who am I? How could I know? So I need a little bit help, guys. I need to know the basic commands on the terminal, how to find something, how to list my partitions, with the designation so that I can mount my home partition as I usually do, then how to search for packages? How I'm going to do this? What can I search else for? So can I search for, let's say, package search, and something with Linux. I want to know Linux doc, Linux fdisk, UPnP internet gateway, Linux plugin support for the native Opera browser, bootloader. So how do I get Linux running, Linux programs running in FreeBSD? I know it works. So what I can do else is I can search for Whisker. Of course, Whisker menu it's so important. I have to go SU. I don't know. If that works, I'll try. So now I go SU, put my super secret password in, and now I say package install dash y. Why would you do this? Because I want to. And here's my Whisker menu. Let's see if it does. Yeah, it does it. So now I can add it. That helps me a little bit out here already. Add new item. We search for Whisker. Whisker menu. Here it is. Add on. There it is. And we move it over. Duran. And kick this one out. Bye bye. And then we have to set the proper behavior. Click, 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 click. And click. And done. So now we have it. See? Everything is here. And here's my simple screen recorder, VLC. Install goes really fast here. I was surprised how quick everything pops in. So yeah, I think I can search. There's just things I can't find, right? There should be a tool how I can run, or a way how to run Linux application in FreeBSD. They even pretend it would run better than it does on Linux. So Vasa 64, Robinook. Or yeah, Ruby Nook. Let me know. I need help here, guys. Help me to walk in FreeBSD. Because for now, I must say, it did a better job than Fanto to me. I could install it. It runs. I'm very confident. I showed that in GhostBSD that I get a printer running. But before that, I think I have a look how to get the NVIDIA driver running, and then I have a proper resolution. And then I should be fine. So if somebody knows how to do all these things, here I am, open for suggestion. Let me know how to do it. And that would be great. I hope you like that video. I have to install maybe Pale Moon. I'm still here, so I can go search. Pale Moon. Do they have Pale Moon? Do they have Waterfox? They have Waterfox. So what we do now is we just go dash y and we install Waterfox. And then we install Pale Moon too. And then we see how that goes. See, it goes pretty quick here, I must say. It's still the old Voyager computer. And it does a good job, and I'm very happy with it. For now. You know, until the first hurdles came, I was happy with Fanto. I was so impressed. I said, yoo-hoo! I haven't erased Fanto yet. No worries. It's still there. But I got Zamba running. Zamba starts. SMB starts. Everything is doing the job. Can't access network. Can't install printer. It reminds me on a very old Linux system I used to... try to advertise to people and figured out it was a nightmare for many little things. This port is depreciated. You may wish to reconsider installing it. This is scheduled to be removed. Okay. So do I have Waterfox here? Yes, I do. Duran, that's not bad. But you see, I want to have my... I can't access them. I want to have my... profile folder from my home partition, which it does not tell me which it is. So I need quite some commands here. I need to know how to identify my partitions, that to get them listed, like with lsblk or bilk, lsblk. So lsblk, for example, doesn't give me anything. This bulk ID doesn't give. So Linux commands do not work here. So that means I have to learn it from the basics, but I'm happy and ready to do it. Will it replace my calculate Linux? No, I need something what just works out of the box all the time, every time I need it. But I'm looking for a second system, right? And I said they have to be independent, and maybe it's good to have a really independent system, having FreeBSD and a proper Linux distro. And why am I not installing Gentoo? I have calculate Linux. I have Gentoo, and I have it in a way like Ubuntu works. It is out of the box. It has all the tools to maintain it. Click installs. Everything is just working fine. Even printer, which seems to be impossible if you just use like Fantoo. I can't judge it for Gentoo yet. I haven't used Gentoo. I just believe that there is a difference. Like in GhostBSD, there must have been a difference, as you can see. I am here and booted into my system without getting stuck at the boot up. In GhostBSD, I did, and I have no idea. This is port is deprecated. You may wish to reconsider installing a temporary experiment to be removed or after to World Voyager SSH key again. Okay. What do they want me to do? A network group machine and share browsing does not work correctly. Oh, some features available to other platforms are not implemented native audio OSS plug and all these things. Okay. Oh yeah, what I want too is do we have Pavu control? Yes, we do. Do we have XFCE? Is it already there, maybe? No, audio is not there. Let's see what I find with FXCE. So I could put on Pavu control, and that could actually give me the plugin for XFCE. That could happen. What's HDOP telling me? Am I rattling here everything? System HDOP. Not too much. My CPU is running low, which is good. Just much searching to do here, I can see. Yeah, you know what I do? I just stop that and I install. See, it's not there anymore. You can't go and then say install, go back like in Linux. At least I haven't figured it out yet. And then I put Pavu control. Did I use an L? E? No, just like that, right? And then I install Pavu control. And it might pull in the XFCE audio controller. That would be nice. So I'm looking for it if it happens. It could, which would be great. But no, it did not. At least I don't see it happening here. Looking for audio. No, it's not happening. Maybe it's a Pavu. No, it's not there either. So it means I have to search for it. XFCE. Let's see what it does. Oh, no, it did something here. Timeout plugin. Pulse audio plugin. You see, that's what I wanted. So for some reason, it didn't do it in the first place. Now it did it. So now I can maybe go install Pavu control. And now I do this. So you're watching me how I start setting up my system. Those are the little things I would like to see. So now I can go in my panel and say, okay, add new item. Now I put in PA. Doesn't work. I use audio. Pulse audio plugin. Here it is. And then I add it on. Here it is now. See? I've got sound. Here's my audio mixers. Simple recording is recording. It seems to be very low. I don't know if the sound quality is okay, guys. So I'm depending on you letting me know. I hope it's doing all good. That sits to very low, but I don't touch it yet. Otherwise, I might mix up my recording. So, guys, I need some kind of a Rosetta Stone for little FreeBSD commands. Help me out if you know a little bit. Give me some basic commands that I know what to do, how to do, and that I can mount my home partition and then create my links. And Vasa, Ruginuki, or let me know, how can I run Linux programs on FreeBSD? It's like an API, Linux API. I don't know if it's written together or if I just go for search. No, it doesn't go for search, and say search and put API, I might just get everything here. Oh, of course, typing. As I said, one day I do a typing course. So here's a lot. XFCE. Oh. So here's lots of API. API sanity checker. Inga extractor. Arbitrace. Capacity. Whatever. I can't find it. Maybe Linux API or something? Linux? Ubuntu, Opera Linux, CPU info, fdisk, Linux dock, DVD wrapper, Linux base, Linux world of Guqin games, I don't know, Linux uplink, Linux TS Maxa, Telegram, Sublime, Skype, Quake, oh, games, oh, good, games. Doom, yeah, we want Doom running here. But so you see, I'm trying to find something which would allow me to run Linux programs, and I try to identify it by searching like this. Seems to be not working. Alza. Okay, so we have to say it doesn't work that way. I need help. Okay, guys, let me know. How would you go? Do you have some kind of a Rosetta Stone for me that I get the basics commands, like listing partitions, mounting partitions? Yeah, I searched for programs that worked. And where's the policy that I can't mount that volume? Error.org, free desktop, edge, LD, device, unknown error. Fstab, etc, fstab, number 5, inappropriate file type or format. Org free dot, blah, 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 permission denied. I don't want to have that policy. So, let me know, guys. I'm a little bit here with a stick in the dark. I'm happy I've got WaterFox now, because with WaterFox, I can go and upload this video. Otherwise, it would just be sitting here. And we can't have that. Okay, guys, I will make order here. Order in the squad. I hope you liked that video. This is me making baby steps in FreeBSD. Help me. I hope you like that video. And I have no icon for it. I will figure that out. I need icons too. So if somebody knows how to get that all in, please let me know. And thank you so much for watching and helping. Thank you, guys. See you soon. Bye-bye.